trees in the rainforest are called a canopy. The canopy is a sunny place that touches the sky. The animals that live there like lots of light. Colorful parrots fly from tree to tree. Monkeys leap from branch to branch. The bottom of the rainforest is called the understory. The animals that live in the understory like darkness. There, silent snakes curl around hanging vines. Graceful jaguars watch and wait. And in this dreaming environment, the great K-pop tree shoots up through the forest and emerges above the canopy. This is the story of a community of animals that live in one such tree in the rainforest.
Two men walked into the rainforest. Moments before, the forest had been alive with sounds of squawking birds and howling monkeys. Now all was quiet as the creatures watched the two men and wondered why they had come. The larger man stopped and pointed to a great K-pop tree. Then he left.
The smaller man took the axe he carried and struck the trunk of the tree. Whack, whack, whack. The sounds of the blows rang through the forest. The wood of the tree was very hard. Chop, chop, chop. The man wiped off the sweat that ran down his face and neck. Whack, chop, whack, chop. Soon, the man grew tired. He sat down to rest at the foot of the great K-pop tree. Before he knew it, the heat of the hum of the forest had lulled him to sleep.
A boa constrictor lived in the K-pop tree. He slithered down its trunk to where the man was sleeping. He looked at the gash the axe had made in the tree. Then the huge snake slid very close to the man and hissed in his ear.
Senor, this tree is a tree of miracles. It is my home where generations of my ancestors have lived. Do not chop it down.
A bee buzzed in the sleeping man's ear.
Senors, my hives is in this great K-pop cheese. I flies from cheese to trees and flies to flowers, collecting pollens. In this way, I pollinate the trees and the flowers throughout the rainforest. You see, all living things depend on one another.
The two little monkeys scampered down from the canopy in the K-pop tree. They chatted to the sleeping man.
Senor, we have seen the ways of men. You chop down one tree and then come back for another and another. The roots of these great trees will wither and die, and there will be nothing left to hold the earth in place. When heavy rains come, the soil will be washed away, and the forest will become a desert.
A toucan, a magpie, and a cop of the rock flew down from the canopy.
You must not cut down this tree. We have flown over the rainforest and seen what happens once you begin to chop down the trees. Many people settle on the land. They set fires to clear the underbrush.
Soon the forest disappears, where once there was life and beauty, only black and smoldering ruins remain.
Along the edge of a reef, in a squeaky voice, she peeped in the man's ear.
Senor, a ruined rainforest means ruined lives. Many ruined lives means many of us homeless if you chop down this great K-pop tree.
A jaguar had been sleeping along a branch in the middle of the tree. Because his spotted coat blended into the dappled light and shadows of the understory, no one had noticed him. Now he leapt down and padded silently over to the sleeping man. grow in the zoo.
Senor, this great K-Pox is home to many birds and animals. If you'll cut it down, where'll I find my dinner?
More tree fox climbs, swung down from the branch to branch, whispered to the man.
Senor, do you know what a bee is and humans need in order to live? Oxygen. And senor, do you know what trees produce? Oxygen. If you cut down the forest, it will destroy what gives us all life.
Anteaters climbed down the great K-Pox tree. The striped anteater said to the sleeping man,
Senor, you are chopping down this tree with no thought for the future, and surely you know what happens tomorrow depends on what happens today. The big man tells you to chop down a beautiful tree. He does not think of his own children who tomorrow must live in a world without trees.
Senor, how much is beauty worth? Can you live without it? If you destroy the beauty of the rainforest, on what would you feast your eyes?
A child from the old Manitoba tribe who lived in the rainforest knelt over to the sleeping man. She murmured in his ear.
Senor, when you awake, please look upon us all with new eyes.
The man awoke with a start before him. He stood the rainforest child all around him, staring where the creatures who depend upon the great K-Pox tree. What wondrous and rare animals they were.
The man looked about and saw the sun streaming through the canopy. Spots of the bright light glowed like jewels amidst the dark rainforest. Strange and beautiful. Plants seemed to dangle in the air, suspended from the great K-Pox tree.
Man smelled the fragrant perfume of their flowers. He felt the steamy mist rising from the forest floor, but he heard no sound from his creatures were strangely silent.
The man stood up and picked up his axe. He swung back his arm as though to strike the tree. Suddenly, he stopped. He turned and looked at the animals and child.
He hesitated. Then he dropped the axe and left and walked out of the rain.
And my heart soars.
Good job.